shutting up like a telescope. Shutting down, closing up, no closing down.
That's not right. Use your words, Nanny tells me.
Well, I'd like to see her try if she was standing where I am now. No, not standing, sinking. That's not right either. This may lead to my going out altogether like a candle. I wonder what I should be like then.
Thank you.
wish I must definitely go.
To that, I shall take to my grave. Sit down, all of you! Listen to me! I'll have you dry soon enough. Now, are you all ready? Silence all round, if you please. This is the driest thing I know. Well, Ian, the conqueror, whose cause was saved by the poor, was soon submitted to my image, who wanted leaders and had been of faith, but I cast no one to suppression, to conquest had been a walker, hell of Mercia and Northumbria. Sambria, Tumbria, Tumbria, Tumbria. I beg your pardon? Did someone speak?
No!
I thought you did. I'll proceed. Sambria, declare and leave its mind as the patriotic cause met up of Canterbury found it. And I
heard what?
Found it. It. Do you not know what it means?
Of course I know. It means generally a frog or a worm. But what did the bishop find?
He found it, advised him to go with William and offer him the crown. William's conduct at first was moderate, but the insults of his nobles soon forced him to reconsider the more shy of the men
of where you came from.
Half those long words all
dance
with me. Doesn't seem to try me at all.
Post haste. Subsequently, consequently, post haste. Post haste.
If you're determined
right to speak. Tell us a story.
A nice one.
A one, one.
One we already know.
Well, far be it from me to oppose the popular will, as did the conqueror William.
You promised to tell me your history, you know, and why you hate, you know. See and deem.
Don't dear paws, my fur and whiskers! It'll be off with his head, sure as peasants are pheasant!
Where are they?
Did I drop them, or have they been stolen? Oh dear, what a curse to be me!
What's taking so long? Never again will I hire human a servant. They are stupid and lazy,
and their ears are too small.
Mary Hyde, I ordered you to fetch my glove.
Oh,
Duchess, an invitation from the Queen to play croquet.
From the Queen, an invitation for the Duchess to play
croquet. Him, shake him, push him when he cries, for we can thoroughly enjoy enjoy the pepper when he pleases. Oh, 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 there's nothing like pepper, says I not. Half enough yet? No, a quarter enough. One for Mrs. Two for the cat. Three for baby. Four for Duchess. One for the tree.
Cheshire Puss, would you tell me, please, which way I should go from here?
It depends where you want to get to.
I don't much care where I get to.
Then it doesn't much matter which way you go.
You only walk around.
Enough! gratitude for success in life. But comings and goings are what life is made of.
Go see the March Hare.
Since March is the month for cutting your hair.
I've seen a cat without a grin, but not a grin without a cat. It's the most curious thing in all my life.
Thank you.
is a raven like a writing desk.
Raven, now we shall look for. I believe I can guess why I made a point of the answer.
Exactly so.
Then you should say what you mean.
I do, at least. I mean what I say. It's the same thing, you know.
Not the same a bit. You might just as well say, I am what I eat. Is the same thing as I eat what I am.
Or, I know what I miss. I miss what I know. They are the same thing.
I am what I eat.
I eat what I am.
I like what I get.
I get what I like.
I kill what I love.
It's the same thing as I love what I kill.
The slightest idea.
Nor I.
I think you might do something better with time than wasting it asking riddles that have no answer.
If you knew time as well as I do, you wouldn't talk about wasting it. Time is a hymn.
I don't know what you mean.
Of course you don't. I dare say you have never even spoken to time. Time and I were once on good terms, but we quarreled last March, just before he went mad. At the great concert given by the Queen of Hearts, where I sang, twinkle, twinkle, little bat, how I wonder what you're at. You know this song, perhaps?
I've heard something like it.
Up, up, up the world you fly, like an ashtray in the sky.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder what you are. Twinkle, sprinkle, little stew, how I thunder what you are.
Twinkle, 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 twink Finished the first verse when the queen bawled out,
"He's murdering time! A
spread!"
Oh, dreadfully savage!
And ever since that, time won't do a thing I ask. It's always 6 o'clock now.
Is that why so many tea things are put out here?
Yes, it's always tea time. And we have no time to wash things between whiles. For you see, all of my life is nothing more than the football of time, the hockey puck of time, the shot put of time, slalom course of time. So it is our fate, our destiny, be arrested by time, sentenced by time, tortured by time, decomposed by time, judged and juried by time, executed by time. That's why I sing time. Oh, time, I beseech you, forgive me my sins. I have not loved you as myself. I have taken in vain thy holy name, worshipped at the feet of gods and of us. Oh, time, I beg for mercy, shed tears of repentance, raining down upon thy holy hands. Fill up my sinews, justified favor, in thine springs and thine. Time. Time, forgive my iniquities, so that goodness and mercy will follow me. The tick-tocks of my life, and I shall dwell in your hand-crafted housing forever.
Like clockwork, but nothing ever changes. I vote the young lady tells us a story.
I'm afraid I don't know one.
Then the Dormouse shall.
Wake up, Dormouse! Tell us a story!
And be quick about it, or you'll be asleep before it's done.
Once upon a time,
there were three little sisters. They lived in treacle and drew all manner of things that begin with an M.
Why? With an M?
Why not?
That begin with an M, such as a mouse, perhaps, and a moo, and memory, and muchness. Much of a muchness! Did you ever see such a thing as a drawing? And a muchness? Snowbys, and memory glass, and margarines, and magic cars, and the mysterious manners of a manta ray! A carver was carrot, magic macaroni master, mackerel master, fool! There we go! And mellow, mellow, need a mellow, mid my mouth, Venus, meantime, meanwhile, then, more, bark, bark, boots! Falling stars, menace, aspects of police, moons, must and menace, where are the spots? I'm not all bad, more gay, not mercy. Victorian bombs, machine gun, legs, meet me fast, men of the
splashing me, and you, seven, stop throwing me down.
Hold the view, hurry. She's due to come by any moment now, even sooner.
You splash me again. Stop your cupping. It's your doing that's caused us such pain.
My doing?
Yes, you, hoping that this is so ignorantly, so mistaken.
Hurry, please hurry.
How could I have known? The tree clearly ordered. Red roses, not white
bushes.
They all open like a famous people.
And nothing, a gate.
That's
only
no gate. Excuse. Ask the Englishman who peeled a tulip.
Queen.
Was thinking it just an onion.
The queen.
And not now in prison.
The queen.
Condemned for the crime of confusing these vegetable roots.
The queen.
Come forth!
consider, my darling, my wise one, this child is only a child.
Just get up! Stop that at once! You make me sick! And what have you been doing here?
It please your majesty, we were trying, so faithfully trying, so trying, so.
I see! Off with their heads!
Nonsense! You shan't be beheaded!
Immature, incomplete, yet odd mutilations do rather excite me. Tell the misshapen lump that it may kiss my hand.
Oh!
wise one. On my own 2 feet, I run to fetch the executioner.
What you do on your own feet is no business of mine. Look, he's here already. My children, a proclamation.
So, darling, it possesses a head, and so, ipso facto, can certainly be beheaded. I've worked in this business for 30 long years, and never have done such a thing.
Makes you forget to talk. There's a moral to that. I shall remember surely.
Perhaps there isn't one.
Nonsense. Everything's got a moral. If you
the moral
of that is take care of the scent and the sound. We take care of the sound. May I pet your flamingo? Flamingo and mustard both bite. And the moral of that is good a feather flock together.
Only mustard isn't a bird.
Quite right, as usual. And the moral of that is be what you would seem to be. Or, to put it more simply, never imagine yourself not to be otherwise than what it might appear to others that what you were or might have been was not otherwise than what you had been would have appeared to them. Unless, of course, what you appeared to them was in fact what you were or might have been and was not otherwise than what you had been would have appeared to them. In which case, never imagine yourself to be anything other but otherwise than what it might appear to others that you were not or might never have been what you never appeared to them. And in so doing, others will never imagine other than what is otherwise than what others appear to you that they were or might have been was not otherwise than what they had been would have appeared to you to be otherwise.
I can't quite follow it. Is you're not very clear?
Then I will simplify further. Never imagine yourself not to be otherwise than what it might appear to others that what you were or might have been was not.
And thus you will learn how life must be lived. For real turtles only speak of that which is real, but mock turtles know all the rest. Up, lazy thing! Take this young lady to the mock turtle. I must go back and chop off more heads.
I was
Well, I was.
Thank you, sir, for your interesting story.
Well, I was. So.
Before that.
Of course, my dear, of course.
Summon the feast, a witness! The first witness! The first witness!
Pardon, your majesty, but I had not quite finished my tea when I was sent for.
You did indeed.
14th of March, I think.
15th, 16th.
Write that down.
Take off your hood.
It's not mine.
Stolen!
I keep them to sell. I've none of my own. I'm a hatter.
Give me your evidence. I'll be
rest of the singers in the last concert.
I'm a poor man, Your Majesty, and I have not begun my tea, not above a week or so. And what with bread and butter getting so thin, and the twinkling of the tea.
Twinkling of what?
It began with a tea.
Of course, twinkling begins with a tea.
I'm a poor man, and even the bread and butter, which must be prepared just so, not to and fro, half in tow, but not so. Justly, as God is surely, justly, so, as the merchant said.
I did it.
You did.
I deny it. He denies it. Leave out that part.
Then the Dormouse said. Then, after that, I cut the bread and butter just so, not to and fro, a half in two.
But what did the Dormouse say?
He said, he said, I can't remember. Is gone. Her pepper, too.
Thank heavens for that.
The next witness is
Alice!
Alice?
proceed until all the jurymen have returned to their proper places. Now, what do you know about this business of the stolen tarts?
Nothing whatever?
Nothing whatever.
That's very important.
He means unimportant.
Important.
Unimportant.
Important.
Unimportant.
Important.
Important. Important.
Let the jury consider their verdict.
That's enough. Rule 42. All persons more than a mile high must leave the court.
I'm not a mile high.
You are!
Nearly 2 miles high.
Well, I shan't go. At any rate, that's not a regular rule. You invented it just now.
It's the oldest rule in the book.
Then it ought to be number one.
Consider your verdict.
Please, your Majesty, there's evidence yet to come. This paper has just been picked up.
Picked up? From where? Try to find any.
There's certainly meaning both in and out of it.
I seem to see some meaning in them after all.
Said, oh, I could not swim.
You can't swim, can you? All right, so far.
We know this to be true.
That's the jury, of course.
If she should push the letter on.
That must be the queen.
What would become of you?
Oh, what indeed?
I gave her what they gave him to.
Why, that must be what he did with the tarts, you see.
But it goes on.
The letter from him to you.
Why, there they are. Nothing could be clearer than that. Then again.
Before she had this fit.
You never had
fits?
My dear, I think.
Never!
Then the words don't fit you. It's a pun.
From friends of Bertie, the Prince of Wales, no doubt. Fire! As dark, as depraved, as the backside of a piano leg. Such perversities can only have sprung from the likes of her. The people
Let the jury consider their verdict.